Wow, I began dancing about 10 years ago. I was always into hip-hop, and I discovered hip-hop when I was a teenager in France.
I started dancing when I was about 5. I don't really know why, I think I've just seen it on TV and kind of interested me. And I started with ballet and kind of just moved on to street dance and kind of went through everything.
Well, I always danced, but it was kind of a mess around dance, like when I was younger. But when I got to primary school, I started like joining dance shows and choreographing my dances with my little friend.
I started like 7 years ago. I danced for 5 years, then I had to stop for 2 years because otherwise I wouldn't keep going with the school.
I remember watching MC Hammer, things like this, you know, and just be interested in street dance. And hip-hop in general.
I was keeping watching films, like step-up films and stuff, street dance. I was really inspired because I was surprised how they could control their body. This is the main thing.
We had a new street dance teacher here at Dunraven when I was in year 8, and I kind of just came along because I knew I liked street dance.
And by year 10 or year 9, I joined the street dance crew, and that's when I started learning how to dance.
I love popping. I need to practice a little bit more. It was mainly because I can control my body, whatever I want, however I want. Because not everyone can do that. Like, it needs practice, like years in practice. That's it. Like, it's amazing how can you control every single muscle of your face, of your ear, of your neck.
I didn't choose it. It's a natural selection. I think I started doing the popping because I just saw a natural rhythm, and you know, growing up in a black family, you know, it's part of my culture. Dancing is always with me. Now I'm doing b-boying, which is the floor dance.
So I'm coming here almost 4 days per week. If I can't come here, I'm practicing in the garden, in the house.
maybe 4 hours a week, in different clubs, different dances.
I wish I was doing more, but when I practice, it's minimum 2 hours. It can be 3. About that $1 million you ain't gonna get.
You can't take it with you. Over in the promised land. Dancer. He got us into dance battles, so that's how we came about, how I actually came about coming into dance battles. And it's something that I always wanted to do as well.
It's different to normal performing because you're actually fighting for something instead of just showcasing what you can kind of do.
Normally when it comes to battles or big performances that I've been involved in the past, I normally just quickly run through the dance in my head.
We kind of listen to a lot of the music so that if it does come on at a battle, you kind of know what's coming and you can move to the music, you know what part of the music's coming up, so it looks better.
I lost my first battle last week actually.
We just won our trophy back, to be honest, and it's fun. So just keep doing what we love and get something of it at the end.
I've practiced in B Supreme London, I've practiced in Eurobattle UK qualifier, I've practiced in Plan B in London, I went to Korea, R16, I've practiced in Battle of the participated in Battle of the Year Germany. I participated in battles in Slovakia, America, New York, Mighty Four, San Francisco, you name it.
3, 2, 1.